Let's continue on with chapter 1. With more overly explanatory tutorials. Why you keep telling me that? As with before, both Kent and Sain's growths will be in the description of both parts of this chapter. Let me know if you want the animations to be turned on or off for the majority of this Let's Play playthrough thing. Now let's give Sain another chance to act like an idiot. Even though 87 hit chance is not that bad, still misses because Sain's an idiot. I can't tell the enemies inside the forest. I was so focused on attacking, I didn't notice the trees. You're gonna get killed before your time, because you don't know basic stuff, and I don't know how to commentate. You don't need to tell me that. Like 49 million times. And now for an overly drawn-out tutorial on trading. I've been stabbed through the face and I didn't notice. I forget how long this takes. Usually skip this dialogue. No, I had to make a let's play of it and show people what the dialogue said. Thanks for telling me what the B button does. In some of the other games, mounted units can move again after attacking if they have movement spaces left. This is obviously not one of them. I think that's the last of the tutorials. Probably do that for most of the characters or bosses, showing off what they are, their little short descriptions. The tutorial speak is finally over for the chapter. This first thing is really self-explanatory, just kill the bandits. Music gets all victorious when you're about to complete the chapter goal. Almost done here. And with Zugu's defeat, that's the end of this part of Let's Play Fire Emblem 7. That's it for the commentary, at least. There's still the rest of the dialogue. I'll see you next time.